he's on the right.
There'll be no further matches in the hallway if cleared. I'm not kidding. We will stop all Marvel games if that hall is not cleared. Now.
Thank you.
Yes. on, man. Guys, fuck that shit!
Quiet.
Thank you.
Thank you. guys, get it down.
Oh, my God.
Let's chewing them, man.
Thank you.
Counted myself, MSP beats Team Rotron, but then I know how mix-up plays, but then for some reason like the controls on Cabinet B are not like good, so I couldn't block all the stuff and basically hit me with a lot of stuff, and my punches were sometimes like worn out, so I can't really like do any like killer resets or killer combos. I basically have to like just turtle and wait until like he gets hit by one of my anti-airs and stuff. Right now I'm just trying to like kill Manuel as fast as possible, because if he touches me once, I'm basically dead. Right here, I tried unfly, but a rocket punch just came out, so I don't know like what happened. Right now I'm just trying to kill Stone as fast as possible, so right now I'm just chipping away. But then Storm is just like, you could tell that by his side, his sticks were working fine. But then right here like. My sticks, I couldn't really unfly, I couldn't really like air dash that well, I kept normal jumping a lot and stuff. And all he has to do is run over to Storm and just fake me, just chip me as well. Because I can't do a lot of stuff. That was like probably one of the mistakes I made in the match and stuff. But then, I still needed like to rack fix this, but then send him back right there. A hailstorm. This is like a really bad, even though like Team Rotron could fight a lot of teams, this must be like one of the worst fights that Team Rotron has to fight. Right now I'm just trying to like fight Psylocke, but then right here I guard cancel, but then it still didn't work because Cable died after that. And right here Fierce came out, but I tried to air dash down so I could hit Psylocke with combo, and I lost the match. I soon realized that I can't play with Team Rotron right now. I had to play with my winning team, Storm Sentinel Cyclops. Right here, I knew he was gonna do the same thing, but then I don't know why I didn't block that. Right now I'm just trying to get a meter so I could DAC out. But then Cyclops will actually fight Manuel better, right, in this occasion than Sentinel. But then I got caught by the Infinite. I don't know what was he thinking about snapping Cyclops out and like trying to go Sentinel. I think he was just trying to reset. Just kept doing the same thing over and over. Just like guard breaking me back and forth and stuff. But then I guess his plan failed, and that's the reason why he lost. If he didn't have to be like all cliche about his infinites, he might have won this match. Or his Magneto wouldn't have died. Like. Like sometimes it's kind of hard for Sentinel to fight Storm Psylocke because if you do get hit by Psyblade, you're not gonna get unfly because it knocks you down to the ground. See right there, I didn't have unfly because I get knocked to the ground easily, and I don't know how I got hit right there. But my Cyclops is like got a lucky super off right there, and I got DC'ing a Storm, and then. I'm like very good at Storm versus Storm matchups, so then it's gonna be like I'm just gonna wait all day and just chip. I charge like meters faster than him, and he is rushed down, so he doesn't like use her full potential. Because her runaway is like basically one of the best things about the game. He was trying to get I think he was just trying to get meter there so he could hit the lightning attack. That was a lightning attack super right there, but then my jab just went out. Went UCFS. Like basically, the match is kind of over because all I had to do against Cyclops is just do standing roundhouse and just hit her a couple like two combos and she's dead. My standing roundhouse like has priority over all her moves. Here. It's much easier because now I can actually have him fly, and then Cyblade is very pain in the butt. He should have stepped with MSP personally, but then this like gives me an easier chance right here. All I have to do is just wait Magneto out. Right there he was dead. I was a DC and Sentinel and he would have died. But then, my hero still died, but right there also, I was supposed to super jump and hit both of them, and then my hero would die, and Cyclops, I would be able to launch Cyclops over again, keep launching and launching, and only Storm was left, and then I would have won much easier. But Cabinet Leaf didn't really want to like work and that stuff. Right here, it's like it's much harder to win this matchup because you know I really don't have Commando, so because Commando like stops her from like staying in the game and stuff. Cyclops really doesn't do that and stuff. I just have to get a lucky like a Gene Splice off and hit her with a Gene Splice, so I might be able to do like a couple of air combos to like damage Storm a lot because you know she doesn't have. Really good defense because all she's like run away, that's why like it's hard to actually hit her, but if you do hit her she bleeds. That unfly right there, it's kind of like very fast to do this stuff. Right here Sentinel dies, my Cyclops doesn't special right there. Canceling the hailstorm. He's dead. Now basically the match is even again. But then I don't know why he didn't want DAC. If he DAC, he could have done short, you know, help her with Magnus, and it would have helped him. It would help him more instead of leaving Cyclops out in the open like that. Right here, Magnus should die right here in air combo, but my air dash is going off. So I did try to just chip him.
Yeah. Yeah! playing in a world that we're supposed to have just the town on the ladder right now?
Thank you. Mission Dust!
Go ahead.
If you want to start calling AC Champions.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Right now?
Go ahead.
Well, I stopped playing Team Roll right now because there's too many MSP players right now. They all just want to jump on the bandwagon. So I'm just going to play Storm Sentinel Cyclops. Well, right here I'm just trying to do is gain two levels against Magnus and just hit him with like a lightning attack and stuff. But then, right here I got greedy, tried to do a fancy combo that's like so unlike me. Right there, maybe I'm supposed to die right there, but then Super Nintendo, but at least the stakes are better than Cabin 2. Now, you know, Ricky Ortiz is like known for his storm, and I'm known for like my storm too, so it's like a storm battle out right here. Even though it's probably gonna be very lame. No super again right there, so don't worry. I didn't expect to catch him right there, so right now I'm just baiting Psylocke out, just trying to kill her because she bleeds very easily and he's just trying to do the same thing to my Cyclops. But then I think mine's worth more because Psylocke hurts so much. She's like has low defense. Right here I don't know what happened, I don't know how Cyclops turned, but then Cyclops did good work. Cyclops was like avoiding all storms attacks. His priority wins is like almost the same as hers. Not as great as hers, but then it's like it's still good ones. But she can just like she can't really do anything because I'm just like holding back and just chipping and pressing rounds on it. And that really overwhelms Storm a lot. Storm's not really a character that gets run from. Storm is supposed to run from other characters. Right here, Psylocke kills me every time it's found. But then, always roll, because sometimes I'll miss. Now, it's gonna be a hard match on for me right now, because my new Psylocke versus Sentinel with no anti yet. So he can just rush me down for free right here. I'm trying to build two levels as fast as possible, but then, I don't know why I didn't DC. I usually match out of Tempest, but then, I don't know why I didn't. I don't know how Storm countered it. But basically, it looks like I probably lose this match because Manuel Psylocke is like, I can't really attack him. And all he's doing right now is just running away. So even if I try to get near him, Sideblade's gonna come out. And then it's gonna counter my attack, his anti hits. Right now, I'm just trying to kill Magnus as soon as possible. Even though he's running away. Every time I get a level, I just have to like chip him with it. But then, if I actually get him in one spot, I can like take him with my center game and like mix up and stuff. But then he just kept jumping up. Basically, I lost that game. This is the second match, and now I know what his plan is, and then I'm gonna counter his plan with my strategy now. I'm just like one touch kill Magnus right now. See, as you can see right there, I blocked it. Not like on Cabinet B where I didn't block against Mix-Up, but I did. Right here, I have two levels now, so Manuel's in danger. He can't really do anything, because I could just like wait until he makes a mistake. And his Storm's roundhouse was going to Magnus. Magnus can't like get past it and stuff like that. Only way is like if his anti just beats the standard roundhouse. Right here, I have to be careful against Storm. Because I can't really fly because if I fly, I'm gonna just gonna get lightning attack all day. So I'll just have to fly low on the ground, using jumping fierce all day, and just trying to knock it down out of the sky. Counter and storm, because I didn't want Sentinel to die, because Sentinel could be used for me later on. Right now, like, I have a better assist than him, because like mine's actually like covers more ground and puts the character more block stun and has more priority than Psylocke. Because Psylocke is like all rush down. It can't like attack you now like a Cyclops can. Cyclops, you know, you could like be able to run away with him and stuff. It protects you so much. Right now he's forced to come to me. So I'm just waiting for him to come to me, call out his assist, and just hail from right there. Now, basically the match is over, I just have to use the roundhouse. As you can see, the roundhouse always back. On the second match, just wait. It's like it's basically like a divide and conquer game. You divide the strategy, like their strategy, so like they can't use it by the full potential. They use it little by little. So I get them frustrated. So they have to like do stupid moves. Cause like I can block all this stuff, so he can't really open me up. And then my sentinel is like a big shield for me. So even if Magnus try to attack. And Magnus probably hit Sentinel because it's so tall, and then Storm will come in and just dash and be standing in the house. And then that's it for Magnus right there, DAC. It's like a very powerful DAC. This is basically an like, even match because I don't have Commando and she could just run away all day. I can't really like, go follow her up there because she'll hit me with lightning attack. And also, Psylocke doesn't give me an earthline. So I basically have to get knocked in the air by Storm's Fierce to get Earthline. But then right now I don't really need it. I can just cover the ground. I don't really have to cover the air. I can wait until she comes down and I'll just chip her little by little. You just have to play smart against like a really good runaway Storm player. You have to like make her waste for meters, but Storm is a very build meter really fast. And all you have to do is just chip Storm all day. See the way I'm like controlling my space between her? Because like she's forced to attack now because I'm winning. And I'm not calling my assist out, I'm just letting her charge up. And this is the cheapest move here. I'm blocking. It's like it's basically a comeback factor. It's very easy to do on MSP. Because two out of three characters might you can just do it for free. And you can do it against Magneto and Salad, but Storm you can't do it. See the strategy to counter this team is basically working kind of well because Magnus can't really rush me down because I have like a whole big wall protecting me. I don't know, I just walked in like, I don't know what happened. See now I basically have 1 meter and he gets hit. He's not dead because like it didn't really hurt him enough, but then it did the damage. He's forced to DAC now. The Storm. And then now, same thing before. Just cover his face. She has to rush down, throw stupid attacks out, and just get whacked. Just get whacked with fierce all this. All the Storm can really do is find a way, like, she has to be sneaky and just like chip me and wait a bit, let me get my help out. But then she's strong, and Ricky's not thinking about that. He's just trying to like find a way in instead of like using his brain. So I'm just waiting for now. The Sandal has 2%, 200% life. Not the Sandal has super armor, so he can take like more hits. So now I made Storm Whistle as me on a meter, and now she's like forced to run away and charge, and then I could just whack her with fierce order. Now she Storm is about to die, I could just like wait, chip her. Because they're forced to either just like sit there all day or do a random attack, random switch up. Right here. See, this is what I'm talking about. You can roll out of it. As you see, I rolled out of it right there. And that messed up the game right there. Because now, Starlight cannot win this match. She can win, but it's highly unlikely because you see, as you see, standing in the roundhouse. All her rounds is beats up her. Jumping roundhouse, crouching roundhouse, standing roundhouse beats all her length of her. Well, this is the final match, and Josh Rick for MSP is like much faster than Ricky's MSP, but then his main character is Magnus. Unlike Ricky's main character is Storm, so basically, if you kill Magnus, you basically win. And all he is about is like rush down. And then I'm a very good person in keeping away, so it's like it's gonna be very hard for him to actually get in on me. Cause like he has a really good rushdown, a reckless rushdown, but then it works out really good. But then I know how like to like just break that rushdown, like break it down. See right here, I'm just waiting for him to make a mistake, cause he's gonna keep trying to jump and trying to open me up, but then it's not gonna work. Cause Storm's like has so much more priority than Magnus, because her limbs are like always beastless. And as you can see, he keeps calling out Sideblade because I'm just like baiting his assist out, and I'm just like raining on both of them. Like if you kill Magnus, you basically have more control of the match because his other two characters aren't like up there yet. As you can see now. It makes it easier for me now to fight Storm because Storm is not as fast as Magnus and not as random as Magnus. It's kind of hard to control Storm because she floats and she comes down at the same time. Right now I'm just like intimidating him, waiting him to cause assist or make a mistake so I can just like kill him. Right here I'm just running, chipping her to death. Because he has to attack me because I'm the one that's like winning by a whole margin. Right here, I got frustrated, got nervous, so he started doing stupid stuff. This is a very good guard break. It's made by one of my friends, so it would help a lot if you use Storm Cyclops. Right here, I'm just like, so he can't really do anything right now. The match is basically over because he's like doing stupid stuff and running into stupid stuff. Match is over.
Do you want to keep going, or do you want to watch the next one?
Okay.
Can you keep going without watching?
Alright,
we'll just do one more. So, versus MSP, and then we'll move on to the other thing.
He beats me a second ago. Well, again, this is his favorite and best team at the same time. So he's basically relying on this team right now. So he's trying to give it a second chance. But then I know like basically all the tricks of MSP because I used to play it. So it's like it's not gonna be very weird, and he's not gonna be able to catch me. Even though like he snapped in Cyclops, my Cyclops like can actually handle on his own and stuff. And now this is a very hard match, but then the, you know, set the, like, I could block, so it's really hard for him to get in, and I'm spacing him out, so he can't really do anything. All I have to do is not get in the corner, like right here. But then I'm out of the corner again. And then I'm back in the corner. So right now he's just trying to, like, rush me down, but then it's not gonna work, because, like, I'm gonna just block and just, like, not stick out any limbs, because Magneto's short, like, only Sentinel can close up. Right now, I'm just, like, wearing him out.